Very good morning to all the students. Today is the last day of last lecture of the lesson Some Natural Phenomena, and this includes the last part of our lesson, that is the earthquakes. Okay students, so in short, first of all, see what is earthquakes. Okay, as the word itself reads, the earth quakes. To quakes means to shake. Okay, the earth quakes. So does earth really quake, students? Earth keeps on revolving, right? So we are going to go in much details, a little details upon what happens when actually the earthquake takes place. So students, there are many natural phenomena just now that we learned about thunderstorms, we learned about lightnings, as well as we learned about cyclones and all these things. But all these natural phenomena, students, they can be predicted. They can be predicted by the weather forecasting department, okay, by the observation department, okay. But earthquakes are really very difficult to predict. Okay, these are very difficult to predict. Okay, these are earthquakes. These are some natural phenomena like earthquakes, which are not so easily predictable. Yes, earthquakes, as you all know, the earth suddenly, wherever you are, suddenly starts to be shaking, suddenly starts to be moving, all what is happening. Okay, it is very harmful, as it is you know that whenever anything starts shaking up too much, you get frightened. Okay, because we need to protect ourselves. But there was some severely strong earthquake in Gujarat areas, in Bhuj areas of Gujarat. We have some details, like on 26 January 2001 in Bhuj district of Gujarat, there was one severe earthquake. Okay, there was also an earthquake, major earthquake in India, in Uri, in 8 October 2005. That was also one of the major earthquakes. Okay, what is actually, student, earthquakes? If you have must have heard of these earthquakes, what is student? It is sudden shaking or trembling of the earth plate. Okay, earth that you stand upon. Okay, there are many parts underground. Okay, they suddenly start shaking and trembling. Okay, when this sudden movements occur, this phenomena is called as earthquake. So how did we define the earthquake? The sudden shaking. Okay, it is not pre-planned, it is sudden. The sudden shaking or trembling of the earth is called as a earthquake. Okay students, now previously in the olden days, people used to know what is the reason behind this earthquake. So as it is given in the textbook, there are two children in our textbook which are frequently used. One of them is Paheli and another is Buju. Okay, two students are there that are learning with you, that are mentioned in the textbook. Out of which they have mentioned that there is a boy called Buju, and his grandmother tells him that when the earth is actually the earth is placed upon the two horns of a bull, and when bull moves, so the earth moves from one of his horn to the second horn, and that is when earthquake happens. This is a story and which is used to explain how the earthquake happens. Okay, as old stories, and in different parts of the world there are different stories about how earthquake happens, but these are all mythological stories. Okay, mythological stories, but they are not real. Okay, they are just prepared. Okay, just for simple things to understand or just have an idea. But what are these earthquakes really doing? They are causing a lot of harm. Okay, they are causing a lot of harm to life as well as property. Like if the earthquake happens in the ocean, it gives rise to tsunamis. The earthquakes. Okay, like we have a major tsunami on 26 December 2004. Okay, in the Indian subcontinent, the Indian Ocean, okay, there was one major tsunami. You remember the date, 26 December 2004. Okay, where all the earthquake took place in the Indian Ocean, and then what happened? Because of the earthquake, the earth started moving in the Indian Ocean, earth plate started shaking, and resulting the water layer, which is still, suddenly got big force of jolt. Okay, experienced large force, and the water moved in the form of huge waves called as tsunamis. So this is how the earthquakes is responsible. So it is India and many other countries suffered a huge loss in property as well as life. Okay, many people lost their lives along with animals, huge buildings were collapsed, and many other things. okay? Yes. So actually, when we see the earth, okay, when we see the earth, if we go into much detail about how the structure of the earth is there within it, then we will be easy to understand how the earthquakes happen. Okay, we'll see just how the earthquakes happen in short. If we just see earth into many of the parts, then first of all, we have the first diagram in your textbook. It is about this diagram only. The diagram which is there, this diagram on the front of your textbook. This is diagram what we are going to talk about. This diagram, this is actually our earth, and this is many different parts of the earth. So we'll draw this diagram and label it in order to understand the structure of the earth and how the earthquakes, where the earthquake begin and how it is caused. Okay, so if we see our earth, which is called a blue planet, okay, spherical, not perfectly spherical though. Now we have this, the outer layer of the earth is called as earth's crust, is called as earth's crust. Now we have to take only one of the parts, so we'll take one view. We have taken it, okay. Now what happens, this part is called as earth's crust, okay. Now which is further divided into two parts, outer crust and lower crust. Okay, this it total together is up till 30 kilometers. Okay, 30 kilometers. And this forms the basis of our outermost part. On this crust itself, we see the ocean parts, the ocean, the all the bodies. Okay, this earth's crust. Okay. Then we have, after the earth's crust, we have the second part, that is the mantle. Okay, we call it the mantle. Now, what is mantle? Mantle is a molten magma. Magma means we all know what is volcano. So in the volcano, if we see, just see, then it is actually very high temperature material which is in liquid form, that is called as a mantle. Even though Earth is about three times larger than Mercury. So the next part is the mantle.
Mercury is 20% of the Earth's total volume.
Yes.
Even though Earth is about three times larger.
Next part is the mantle. And after the mantle,
Mercury
we have
is 20%
outer core and the inner
Earth's
core.
Total volume.
This is the
even
outer
Earth
core
is about
and
three times larger
core.
Than Mercury. Mercury is a.
Okay. Yes. This is the outer core. Outer core and inner core. Inner. Core. Now this is how the structure of the earth is. Okay, this is where we stay upon the earth, if you see. Okay, then as you go deep inside the earth, it becomes more dense. It is a little lesser dense. It is still lesser dense. Okay, the density increases as you go deep into the earth. This is highly dense material. Okay, yes. Now you must be saying that as we go deep into the earth's crust, the density of the earth, density means what? How strong, how much compact all the mass is situated at one place. Okay. Density of the earth and temperature increase. The mantle is up till 2900 kilometers. The mantle layer is up till 2900 kilometers. Write down this. And the core together is 3500 kilometer, which is together outer plus inner. Okay, core outer plus inner is 3500 kilometers. Now what happens, there are many reasons for earthquakes. First of all, if you see, then the crust is made up of plates. Plates means what? land plates. Okay, now if you just imagine this in situation of a coconut, the coconut, then the outer surface of the coconut is just like a one huge earth's crust. So what is that? That is a plate, that is an outer plate. So how that earth is prepared? That is an outer plate. So it is formed by number of plates. Okay, one plate is formed of number of plates. Now what happens? These plates, okay, these plates due to movement, okay, this is molten liquid, molten mantle is a molten lava. That means what? You have this defined as molten magma. Magma means very all the materials, the natural materials, minerals and all the solids under the earth's crust are in the form of high temperature liquids. Okay, they are melted into the form of, and all are melted at high temperature and together are called as molten magma. Okay, now number of plates are there in earth's crust itself. Now all these number of plates tend to happen to move over each other. That is means what? They collide. Earth's collide. Now if there is a plate, if there is an earth plate on the crust, and there is another such plate. Now because of the movements of the magma which is there inside liquids is there, here there is liquid. If this moves, then it might move the plates. The plates move over each other and plates collide. When the plates collide, it creates tremors. It creates tremors. Means what? It creates motion. Like for example, if I have two books with me. So like for example, these are the two plates. Earth is formed, and if two plates are there, and beneath the plates there is huge molten liquid, and if due to certain movements these plates which are forming the earth's crust, they move, then what happens? If we are people situated on the earth, so what happens if the plate moves? So what happens when the plate collides? What happens? All the people on the plate, that is the life that we all which are staying above the plate, will experience tremors, right? So first one that we are learning is plates collide. That is why the earth shakes or trembles. Okay, this is called as earth tremors. Okay, this is called as tremors. So we can say the earthquakes because of the first part, that is collision. And what is the second part? Brushing of plates. Brushing of plates means what? Now, just as these two plates, as we were talking about these two plates. Now, if these two plates happen to just brush over each other, means they are situated upon the mantle, but suddenly what happens? They are steady, but suddenly they happen to brush each other. Then what happens? If they brush each other, then what happens? Again, we experience tremors. Tremors means what? Sudden shaking. Okay. So even then, at that situation, we might experience what? We might experience this. Okay. We might experience brushing. That means if this moves ahead, this moves forward, then again we experience what? Tremors. Okay. I will show the tremors with the help of a red color. These are tremors. Okay. Tremors. Tremors means what? Sudden shaking vibrations. Okay. Okay. So experience. So these two are the causes that experiences tremors. Tremors means what? Vibrations. Okay, these two are the main responsible causes. Okay, the main responsible causes for the earthquakes are the earth plates which are formed on which we are staying. Okay, the Indian subcontinent plate, okay, the Australian plate, all these plates are there, many plates are there. When these plates under the just as they are forming the earth's crust, they just collide over each other, then we feel tremors. Okay, we feel waves, we feel vibrations. One of the reasons, as well as the second reason, is brushing of the plate. There are two plates, they brush over each other, again tremors are felt. So that is another reason. The third reason is that the molten magma from this part, third reason is that, which is not from the crust, the third main reason it's coming, and because of the from crust we have two reasons, and from the molten mantle, the second reason is, if the molten magma from mantle okay, forces out, okay, it disturbs the plates which creates tremors. Means what? The mantle which is there here inside the in the below the earth's crust, if it due to the movements, due to the earth is rotating and also it is got a very high temperature, if suddenly it has got high temperature also, okay, and as it comes, wants to come out, it disturbs the plates which are there, which are just floating above this molten liquid. It just forces out and then its alignment get disturbed, and again because of this the earth plate might again brush over each other or they might collide each other. So there is no cause for it. It can happen due to natural movements. That is why we cannot predict it, because there is no defined cause for it. It can move out because of its own natural the liquid, it is earth is moving, they can move in any random directions, so it can move out. But student, one thing that we can predict, what is that? We can predict zones or the areas where these boundaries are situated, where these boundaries are situated, and we can safeguard that places, okay, the places where these boundaries of plates lie, we can protect those places, like we can create stronger houses there, or we can use a very light material above the house so that even if earthquake happens, we might be safe. So what are those plates called? Those plates where the earthquakes, the plates are in contact, are called as weak zones. These are called as weak zones. So such places are called as what? Weak zones. Such places are called as weak zones. Okay. So I will rub this diagram. You pause the video and draw this diagram in your notebook. Okay. So such places are called as weak zones, especially when these plates lie. What are these called as? Weak zones. Weak zones. What are weak zones? Let us see. Okay. Yes. Earthquakes caused by the movement of plates. The boundaries of the plates are called as weak zones. So what are weak zones? These boundaries of the plates are called as weak zones. These boundaries of the plates. Okay. Where you might experience a maximum earth tremor. The boundaries. Okay, all these boundary part, these boundary part are called as weak zones, isn't it? It is called weak zone because it is not standing on any firm part. This is strong because it is standing on the earth's stronger part. But here it is, contact is very, not strong contact is there, weak contact. That is means it is weak. Okay, so boundaries of the plates are called, also called as fault zones, called as fault zones. Fault zones. So what we can do, we can identify such places and we can make those places more strong. Now what are those places? Those are given in textbook. So we will see what are those. These are some places, like for example, we will write few of them. Okay, few of them are given in the textbook. Those are, see, Kashmir. In Kashmir, there are certain, these situations are observed where plates are, just two plates are connected towards each other, or they are loose, boundaries are there. Okay, that means fault zones are there. So what is that? In Kashmir. So you might should know this. In Kashmir, in India, all the areas in northeast, all the areas of northeast. Okay. Northeast means Sikkim, Assam, all these areas, right? Next, Run of Kutch, Rajasthan and Gangetic Plain. That means the basins of River Ganga. Okay, Run of Kutch, Rajasthan and Indo-Gangetic Plain. Indo means Indus Plain. Okay, all these are weak zones. Okay, all these are weak zones. On these weak zones, we should be identified identify and we should keep our responsible belongings very strong, like our property, house. Okay, now what need to be precautions? Precautions are there, but just now we have studied weak zones. Precautions we study after some time. So how is this identified? How is the power of the earthquake understood? Like, for example, students, there is a machine. Okay, there is a machine called as seismograph. There is a machine called as seismograph, which actually measures the earthquake. Now, how does this measure? See here. If I have this as earthquake, okay. For example, this is an earth, okay, and on this earth plate there is a machine called a seismograph. Now, what is this seismograph machine? This is actually nothing but a piece of cylindrical device on which there is a paper wound. Paper is wound on it. Now, what happens as the plates disturb, plates move, okay, wherever the, this is placed at weak zones. What happens as the plates move, then what happens? The earth moves around the plate, earth moves with the plate. So what happens if the earth moves, and then what happens? The earth moves, the cylindrical also moves, but this plane is made flexible. So what happens if the earth moves, so, and it is made to rotate with a motor. On a motor it rotates. So as the earth moves, and earth suddenly starts moving very largely, strongly, so what happens? It is recorded on this machine. Now what is this cylindrical machine do? It is actually a graph paper, and when finally the earthquake is over, then this graph paper is removed out, and it is measured like this. Now what is this? This is telling you the actual magnitude of the earthquake, means how powerful the earthquake was. It was more strong than it was. It would record more reading. Okay, so that is actually the earthquake recording machine, that is called as seismograph. What is it called as? Seismograph. Okay, earthquake is measured. Okay, magnitude of earthquake, that is the power of earthquake, is measured by seismograph. Now, what does seismograph do? Actually, we had seen this on a just a demo of it. So, a recording is done on a paper. Okay, and suddenly if earthquake stops, it is like flat line. Okay, this is a reading. And this reading, if you measure it, then its reading is measured in units. And what is the name of the new unit? Like you measure mass in kgs. So, what is the earthquake is measured in? Reading is measured in Richter scale unit. So this is a new unit, Richter scale unit. This is the unit for measuring Richter scale. Now for measuring earthquake, that is Richter scale. Okay. Now on this graph, it is written here 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. If suddenly it happens that this tremors reach to 7 point, if it reaches to 7, suddenly if at point, let us say it reaches 7, so that means the earth was moving with very high and dangerous vibrations. So when the tremors are more than 7, so it is dangerous. So when the earthquake with more than 7.5 Richter scale, it is dangerous. Means what? The earth always has earthquakes going on, because it is, the earth's crust is floating on the mantle, so earthquakes keep on happening every time. Now also the earth is moving. Actually there is very small amount of earthquakes happening to us, but what happens that these are so small. Now also earth, if you place this on Richter scale and if you move, then also you will see a very small, earth is also moving now also, but it is moving very small, in very small magnitudes. You happen to see it is moving very, very, very small magnitudes. In very small magnitude it is moving. almost. So each and every time earthquake is happening around us, but we cannot sense it because the magnitude is very small. But suddenly if the magnitude becomes more than 7, earth starts moving with more than 7.5, then all the property around will start to fall and it will be very dangerous. The living beings, the houses, it will be, the houses and all the property will be in a tremendous loss when the magnitude is becoming more than 7.5. So this unit is called as Richter scale. This unit is called as Richter scale units. The device that measures, that we have discussed, is called as seismograph. The device is called as seismograph, that device we just saw. Okay, the reading is called as Richter scale unit. The seismograph, that is a simple cylindrical diagram. As we have seen, it is a paper and there is a pen, a flexible pen. This seismograph diagram, it's there in the textbook. It's very easy to draw. We are not going to draw it on the board. So you have to draw it. Yes, few more points that are discussed in the lesson, that is epicenter. Epicenter means the actual point where the earthquake has begun. That is called epicenter. If you talk about the plates, then this will be the point of epicenter, that is at the fault zones. Yes, epicenter means the point at which the maximum earthquake begins. Okay, let us see what is the proper definition of it. Yes, epicenter. There isn't any proper definition, I think so, in the textbook, but epicenter is the place where the earthquakes actually begins its waves, because as the earthquakes, the vibrations are maximum at the epicenter, because as the vibrations move and flow out, it becomes, its magnitude becomes less. Less means what? It doesn't, you don't sense it. So the earthquake's magnitude is maximum where? At the epicenter. At the epicenter. If the earthquake has happened in Gujarat, then its epicenter is there in, that means the epicenter is there in Gujarat. As you come to Maharashtra, its magnitude is becoming less, as you just have a stone and you throw it on water. So the when the stone hits the water, at that point we call that is its epicenter. As you move away, the magnitude becomes less. So what is epicenter? Epicenter is the point where the tremors are felt maximum. Okay, the tremors are felt maximum. Okay, strongest. Next, protection. So what are, how to take protection if you are inside the house and if you are outside the house? There are two things that are to be discussed in this lesson. Okay, how to take the protection, precautions. How to take the precautions. So if you are inside the house, then what can we do? What we can do is we can create a quake safe building. Okay, if you are inside the house, you can what are the precautions? While constructing the building itself, you have to make sure that the building is made quake safe. Quake safe means even if earthquake happens, the building will not fall. Okay, that is, it should be quake safe. What is the second point that is given in the textbook? That is, consult a qualified architect. That means you have to consult a qualified architect while building itself. That is very important. While construction only, you should take care of this. What is the third point? Third point is the roofs. That the roofs should be of very lighter material. Yes. The roofs should be of lighter material. Yes. Like of mud and timber. mud and timber. And where should these precautions be most taken? Okay, preferably at the weak zones. Preferably at the weak zones, not at the places where it is not possible to, not the earthquakes are going to happen. Okay. What is the next one? The next one is, yes, earthquakes, because earthquakes also result in the disturbance in the building, so it is possibility that the electrical equipments may catch fire. Okay, so we need to have proper firefighting equipments. Firefighting equipment should be there. Equipment should be there. And finally, if you are having some photo frames and all the things, then you should keep it towards the wall, not in the building, in the middle, anywhere. So photo frames and all. Equipments should be at the wall. Should be not at the middle anywhere. Okay. Carefully hanged. Carefully hanged. Okay. Not at a place where if it falls on your head, so it might not harm you. Okay. These are the things that need to be taken precaution when earthquake is earthquake in more earthquake zone. Earthquake. Prone zones, okay, like in near Maharashtra, we have at Koyna. So at that places, tremors are felt very more. So you can say that those are weak or fault zones, but in that places, you need to really take care of these things at Koyna. At places like Koyna, we need to really take care of these things because at those places, the quakes are felt most frequently. Okay, so how would you take care when you are inside the house at any place? Like for example, here at Khed or Chiplun, if you are and you need to have get protected. So what would you do if you earthquake happens at that place? Inside a house. Inside the house, first one. Inside the house, if you are there, then how would you protect yourselves? Yes, first one. Go under the table. Simple. Go under the table. Go under the table. Yes. And second one is what? How to protect yourselves? The second one is stay away from tall objects. Like for example, in your house there are tall objects. Like for example, there is some certain pillar. Okay, the pillar or there is certain cupboard, huge cupboard. So it might fall upon you. So stay away from that. Okay, stay away from tall objects. Stay away from tall objects. Very good. Yes, what is the third point? Third point is, if you don't find anything, then protect your head from a pillow. Protect your head from pillow. Yes. And then finally, you have outside the house. Outside the house, you have, what can you do? Yes, outside the house, what are you supposed to do? Yes. If you are outside the house, then find a clear spot. Means what? Go on to the ground. On ground, what happens? There is no building, so you nothing will fall upon you. So find a clear spot. Find a clear spot. Yes. And what is the last one? If you are in a car or a bus, then you go again in a vehicle. If you are in a vehicle, are in a vehicle, then drive slowly to a clear spot. So don't drive fast, because if you drive fast, there are chances that if there are any movements, it might harm you a lot. Okay, you have to drive slowly. So I think so most of the points we have discussed. Yes, so we have almost covered all the lesson in 5 segments. Yes, there is nothing remaining for the textbook. Yes. Okay, students, now we have almost covered the chapter. Now, we expect you to write down all that we have discussed in summary and submit the summary to the class teacher, or not the class teacher, to your respective teachers, and finish all the assignments that is given at the end of the textbook, the exercises. Yes, and one task is there for you. You have to collect the pictures of the earthquakes, like for example, you any newspaper cuttings if you have, and you might take it. Okay, students, thank you.